Imagine tiny robots made of living heart cells swimming towards you being guided by laser light. Well, now that's a thing. We live in the future, people. Hello everyone, I'm Crystal here for DNews. In what seems like a plot from a science fiction film, scientists have now created tiny swimming robots shaped like jellyfish and stingrays. They claim to be using these mechanical copycats to study propulsion, test biological materials, and find new vehicle designs. But I can't be the only one imagining swimming armies of tiny robots, am I? I didn't think so. When mechanical objects like this mimic biological systems, it's called biomimicry. Some scientists believe that since biomimicry builds on millions of years of evolution, it's a more effective and efficient approach to engineering. In my favorite recent example of this, a team of scientists led by Kevin Parker at Harvard created a 1/10 scale version of a rayfish with a tiny gold skeleton and a rubber body that's powered by approximately 200,000 rat heart muscle cells. This biological hybrid machine can swim through an obstacle course in a salt solution with a little help from lasers. It's so creepy. The reason they used heart cells is because of the way that they beat, contracting together in response to stimuli. They started by placing the heart cells on top of the robot, but these weren't ordinary heart cells. They were modified to contain a light-detecting protein usually found in our eyes, making them activate in response to light. This meant that the researchers could signal the cells to contract simply by flashing a light at them. When activated, the cells contract down, bending the skeleton, and when they release, the flexible wings rebound to neutral, just like a live ray or the beating of a heart. So now they can make the robot swim, but since the contraction of the cells happened on both sides of the mechanical ray at the same time, the robot was impossible to steer. So they further modified the cells to make the ones on the right and left wings responsive to different wavelengths of light. Flashing both wavelengths at the same time caused the ray to swim forward, but flashing one or the other activated only one wing of the ray and could turn the vehicle. After accomplishing this, the team did what anyone would do, really, and started building obstacle courses for their robot like they were designing a biomimetic video game. Robot biohybrids are relatively new, and others have mimicked aquatic animals like sea turtles, jellyfish, and now stingray. Obviously, this is really cool, but why do we want to build robots out of biological materials in the first place? Well, Stanford professor of engineering John O. DeBeery says it all comes down to energy. With traditional robotic systems, DeBeery says, quote, the robots would run out of energy before they took over the world. But biological systems are really efficient at using energy. If you want to make smaller, more powerful, faster robots, improving energy use is a good way to do that. Biomimetic jellyfish or stingrays don't require batteries, gas, or solar panels. They use the same source of energy as the rest of our cells in the body do, glucose, a form of sugar which scientists put in the water to feed the cells. So at this point, the robot only swims if it's in a glucose and salt solution at body temperature with particular light waves flashing at it. But it's still an exciting step forward to making biomechanical robots that sense, respond, and move on their own. In other words, intelligent robots made from live biological materials could be coming soon. What could possibly go wrong? To learn more about the ways human engineering can benefit from biomimicry, check out this video by Trace.
When are we going to design buildings that look like they were grown? When are we going to make houses that look like shells and solar panels and wind farms that look like big trees? I mean, some of this stuff has already started, but I want to see more of it.
If you could make any robot that mimicked any animal, what animal would you choose? Let us know down in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to get more DNews every day.